Well, the Bulls continuing their fortnight of a homestand, trying to get back in the win column after losing three of the first four games to the Gwinnett Stripers. This is Patrick Keenis for Durham Bulls Daily, which is where our Bulls fans know to go the morning after every Durham Bulls game for scores, for news, for nuggets and highlights, everything that is Durham Bulls. And you can subscribe and never miss an episode. Do that on Apple or Spotify or any place that you get your podcasts. And you can also watch our video pod of this little vignette on our YouTube channel at Durham Bulls TV. Well, the Bulls came in 18th place in the 20-team table in the IL, five games under 500 and six games out. So the Bulls need to make a push quickly to try and get back in this race. And they had Jacob Lopez going against the top prospect in the Braves organization, A.J. Shauver. And Lopez outpitched him tonight. Six scoreless innings, striking out eight, only allowing three hits. Lopez would earn the win as the Bulls shut out Gwinnett 3-0. Not a lot of offense in the game, but three long hits by the Bulls. It was 0-0 into the bottom of the third when Tristan Peters hit a home run to give the Bulls a 1-0 lead. The next inning, it was C.J. Hinojosa hitting a solo home run against Smith Shauver for a 2-love lead. And then in the bottom of the fifth, leading things off, Junior Caminero.
And break ball driven out to left field. Caminero, woo! Three out of three. A solo bomb to left field. Bulls third in the last three innings against Smith Shauver. And it's now a 3-0 Bulls advantage in the fifth.
Home run by Caminero, his 10th, would give the Bulls a 3-0 lead. Lopez went six innings to earn the win. Then we saw Drew Rasmussen continue his big league rehab in relief for the first time, and he goes two innings for the first time. 28 pitches, dominant again, 96-98 from the right side from Rasmussen. He was terrific for the Bulls. And then Erasmo Ramirez closed things down, earned his fourth save of the year in a fairly uneventful top of the ninth inning with a couple of strikeouts. So the Bulls with the win, 3-0. Speaking of Caminero, he was batting leadoff in the lineup for Morgan Ensberg for the first time this year. Generally, it's been Cameron Meisner almost every game in which Meisner starts. He bats leadoff. The previous night, last night, it was Oslavius Basabe batting leadoff. And tonight, it was Junior Caminero. He started the game with a 114-mile-an-hour blistering single. Singled again in the third ahead of that home run in the fifth inning off of Smith Shauver. So the Bulls pick up the win. They're 11-15, and the first portion of this Bulls homestand closes on Sunday afternoon. Ian Seymour, who made his Bulls debut back on Tuesday against Gwinnett, will circle around and take on the Stripers again. Darius Vines, who beat the Bulls on Tuesday, is expected to oppose. That'll be a 5:05 first pitch between the Bulls and the Stripers. A win, and the Bulls will suddenly split this six-game series and then have an off day before the homestand resumes against Memphis on Tuesday night. So again, the Bulls defeat the Gwinnett Stripers by a final score of 3-0. That's going to wrap it up for Durham Bulls Daily. Again, subscribe if you can, Apple and Spotify, or you can subscribe to our YouTube channel, Durham Bulls TV. Final score, Durham 3, Gwinnett 0. I'm Patrick Keenis for Durham Bulls Daily.